Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good morning everyone. We are from group 6. Today we'll present our material about control recommendation of pests and disease in coffee plant. But before we start our topic today, let me introduce my friends. Next. First is Farel Arda Pradipta with student ID 111. Ananda Fitrianta Susilo with student ID 113, Hanifah Salsabila with student ID 114, and Lutfi Nandarista with student ID 132. Next. Table of contents about our material. First is introduction. This describes about coffee plant in general and varieties of coffee like Arabica and Robusta. And then second is pest disease identification. This describe of the pest or disease and their symptom. Third is control recommendation. This describe of pest or disease control recommendation from us. Next. First is introduction. Coffee is an annual plant that has three vegetative organs, namely root, stem, and leaves. Coffee plants have two types of branch growth, namely autotrophic and plagiotropic branches. Arabica coffee has flexible and thin leaf branches. The shape of the coffee leaf is oval. The tip is slightly tapered. The leaves grow on the stems, branches, and rhizomes that presents. The leaf arrangement of the choice of branches alternates and grows on both the flat and the flat. Mature leaves are dark green, while young leaves are brown. Coffee plants that are commonly cultivated in Indonesia are Arabica and Robusta coffee. Next. This is the classification of coffee plants: Kingdom Mixplantae, Subkingdom Traceobionta, Superdivision Spermatopita, Division Magnoliopita, Class Magnoliopsida, Ordo Rubiales, Family Rubiaceae, Genus Coffea, and Species Coffea Robusta L and Coffea Arabica L.
We talk about pest and disease identification. The first one is coffee steam borer. The adult is a butterfly with thick four wings, transverse downward at the top. Use the Rafaela by the Rowyong's coffee stems. Yes, and branches with a diameter of about 3 cm. The length of the hoist canal can reach 40 until 50 cm, with a diameter 1 until 1.2 cm. In the secondary part, the characteristics of coffee in water. The first one is the branch above the grill part is dead. Second, this cut the peanut to make the steam branches with grinding the pit for silence of the stems or branch. Then, turning upwards to attack you through the cartera holes. The plant parts above the grill all lungs, wither, dry, and die. The last one, the effect of the species disperse the leaf, the underground necrosis, and next is coffee berry borer. The coffee berry borer, her home berry, develops with complete metamorphosis starting at the egg, larva, pupa, and imago stages. In general, Fruit can also be attacked. Coffee cherries, wood seeds, shells off, are generally only picked up and then left. Cherries not develop color changes to reddish yellow and then falls. Symptoms of the methods with GKO are related to behavior in life. Digital is a direct pest category, meaning that it directly damages the harvested plant parts, namely the crop The female beetle boosts the apical part of the fruit, usually visible excrement of the fruit in the inlet. There are parts of the wood housed by the press, mainly young fruit fall and loss of meal in quantity and quality. Next is Upas fungus or fin disease. Upas fungus or fin disease is caused by Upasia salmonicolor, or also known as Protozoan salmonicolor, which is widespread in tropical areas around the world. This disease has a very important meaning in coffee cultivation because it can affect the stems, branches, roots, and berries of coffee. The characteristic of Upas fungus, Upas well is typical symptoms of Upas fungus attack our branches or that are attacked. Attacks can occur on branches now in the middle or at the end of the tree. It can occur in the trunk. Second, in the form of small disease, which generally have died due to this fungal attack. The last one, the attack on the begin with necrosis from the base of the first fungus. Extend to entire surface and reaches the endosome.
Okay, then is coffee leaf rust. Leaf rust disease caused by fungus Hemilia pastatricbr. It's an important disease in coffee plants in the world that attacks Arabica and Robusta. Control efforts are carried out by eliminating Arabica coffee with Robusta, but this disease is still a problem in all coffee production in Indonesia, and it can reduce by 20 until 60%. This disease attacks coffee plants in nursery and plants. The characteristic of leaf rust, the first is the symptom of leaf rust disease can be seen on upper and lower surface of the leaf. Marked by yellow orange like powder. And second is infected leaf appears yellow spot and then turn brown. And last is a later symptom on the leaf or a spot that merge with each large and dry up and fall. In a heavy attack, almost all the leaf fall so that the plant will look pale. This is a post-harvest pest or Araceus fasciculatus. Insect that attacks soy production are found on the small size, perfect shapes, drug profile, hidden under protonum, tip of abdomen, visible between elytra, 3 to 4 millimeter long. The larva are found in the dry coffee bean, also in the roots of the cassava tuber, maize, cocoa bean, and the rest of good such as cocoa beans. Their refill are agile, but will pretend to be dead if disturbed. The characteristics are Araceus fasciculatus. Coffee weevil. The first is the or with the spread destroy of coffee bean supplies in warehouse, resulting in weight loss and contaminating. Second is these beetles. This beetle is an important pest in coffee and cocoa beans. Besides O2, it can also attack peaches, corn, peanuts, and some food products. Okay, the next is control recommendation about the disease. The first, control coffee bean borer. The first, we can assess by picking all the fruit of the tree after harvest. This can break the life cycle of this pest. The second is burning. And avoiding high humidity.
The third is using predator in the coffee plantation, including spiders, worms, pickpockets, mantids, dung beetles, tiger beetles, green beetles, dragonfly, and several kinds. Using parasitoid, namely Stephanopsis, Chapalonomia, and Prorus nasuta. And Pimaticus coffee, coffee equala, Heteropicus brajonic, and originating from Africa, and the last is Bavaria basiana.
Next is control coffee stipper. So first is crossing the host and spread the larva, cutting the protected stems of plants 10 cm below the host, then destroy the larva. Second, example with Bavaria basiana. Third is single control is used when damage caused by insect pest cross the threshold. Cover the threshold with cotton that has been treated with infused plants with systemic insecticide, either through stem or root tips. Next, control coffee upas fungus or pink disease. First, cut off disease branch. Second, reduce humidity, burning, and setting shade trees. Third, using for fungicides such as Noptox, Cuprofit, or a tridimorphic fungicide. Fourth, eradication by pig collected or buried disease fruit. Fifth, using Pseudomonas. Next, first is using resistant varieties. Second, technical culture includes weeding, fertilization, pruning, and seed management. Third, vegetable fungicide extract from mahogany with a concentration of 0.1 until 0.2% was effective in suppressing leafless disease. Fourth, chemical fungicide used to control leaf rust are usually common. For example, Noctox, Cocide, Profit, D10 applied with concentration of 0.3% to weak up. Control for herbicide pest or Araceus fasciculatus. First, for control before attack reduction, coffee beans can be tightly wrapped with mallet material so as inside the packet. Second, reducing the moisture content of seed by drying. Third, warehouse and environmental sanitation. And fourth, using natural enemies such as Anseromalus calandrae, Cephalonomia calicola, Amandales araceus, Cephalonomia calicola, Cleonimus technus, Eupelus kusmani, etc. That's all from us. Thank you for your attention. If there is any question, please ask in the forum in Pada. Thank you.